Month it was arranged better table, same place. When Kapil Sibalji came, you guys arranged good.
Table pai kunde.
Yeah, put table pai kunde. Why I don't know. Should we change? No. I can't speak loud because my voice is gone. I'm speaking 22 hours a day. Okay, sir. Sorry, my voice is not that good because I'm speaking practically 20 to 22 hours a day, campaigning in Andhra and Telangana and working throughout day and night on peace mission. I want to thank Prime Minister of Pakistan, Mr. Khan, and Mr. Amir, my good friend, and other senior advisor who have done their part properly, ethically, to release our Indian hero, the pilot Abhinandhan. And I hate to see the Indian politicians taking advantage of the situation as if they have done something to release the pilot. And I have warned in the same hotel on December 25th, along with my good friend Mr. Kapil Sibal, many of you have attended the press meet 2 months ago. We warned, I warned, Kapil Sibalji warned, when Ahmed Patel and others came to meet me, that Prime Minister Modi is going to declare a war with Pakistan for politicizing the situation. And that's exactly what happened days ago. I was here that 3 days ago, again hosted by my good friend JP Naddaji, Union Minister of Health, and my good friend Kiran Rijiju, who traveled with me to America, Syria, Libya in 2005 as MP, along with 17 parties. He hosted me 3 days ago, you saw it, especially the Telugu media. And I warned them, don't go for unnecessary war. And then Prime Minister met my good friend Union Minister JP Naddaji, 4:30 to 5:30, and JP Naddaji and I again met that evening, 3 days ago. And they assured me peace talks and they stroke at 3 a.m. while I was in the airport. This is nothing but nonsense. We don't need another war with Pakistan. Yes, Pakistan must do everything to stop terrorism. They must control their border. They must arrest the culprits. I've been the state guest of Pakistan with Benazir Bhutto and Musharraf. And many of you know that 2005 and 2002 and 2007 and 2016, I've been hosted by various prime ministers of Pakistan along with our Indian prime ministers. War should be the last option or no option at all. But thank God our pilot is back, and I hope just 2 months before Indian elections on April 30th, especially in our south, Andhra and Telangana MP elections, I hope that this government, to galvanize the Hindu vote, will not declare another war. No matter what they do, BJP is not coming back in power. As I told Modi ji recently, Amit Bhai recently, and Nadda ji recently, you will not come back to power. People have given you one chance, and that's it. Because you failed in all your promises, Acha Din, black money release, job creation 10 crores in 5 years, secularism, but you delivered communalism, Whatever Modi ji promised me 2010 January 25th, he did not deliver, and he didn't deliver to the people. He had 31% vote bank. Now he will have 20 to 22% vote bank. Instead of 282 seats, they will have between 125 and 140 in the upcoming election. So secular front, third front will be forming the government, for which Kapil Sibal ji joined me and others hands since August 2017. Keeping that aside, why did I enter politics, especially in Andhra Pradesh and Telangana? Why are we contesting elections? Number one, to promote secularism. As I stated, December 25th, India is at crossroads. India is in dangerous situation. Just look at three statements. Sri Sri Ravi Shankar ji last year said, no, let me finish in English for the English media. Then I'll come back to Telugu. Sri Sri Ravi Shankar ji said, if the temple is Ram temple is not built, India will become Syria. Syria is a disaster. 2.5 crore people dying. 4-5 lakhs have died in this country. 4-5 lakhs died outside the country. I've been in the last 6 months in Lebanon, Jordan, Turkey, with 10 lakhs refugees from Syria and Libya. And you know, I've been advisor to Syrian and Libyan presidents. And then MIM leader from Hyderabad said, OS, if BJP comes back in power, it will be like, India will be like Rwanda, Burundi. And you know, I've been the head of state dinner speaking at Rwanda, Burundi parliaments. And so many Indian parliamentarians traveled with me from all 17 parties. It's dangerous. 9 lakh people have been killed in 90 days in Rwanda in 1994. When Bill Clinton was president. So we don't need Syria, we don't need Rwanda, Burundi, African genocide. What we need is secular India, which is known for beautiful India, incredible India, peaceful India. Hindus, Muslims, Christians, Buddhists, Jains and Sikhs and Jews all come together. That's the beauty of India. I've been promoting in 155 countries since 1989, living in America. So therefore, I started a political party because in India, you see what happened between BJP and Congress, why Kejriwal came into power, sweeping the entire Delhi, 67 seats out of 70. Defeating BJP, leaving them only with 3 seats, and wiping out Congress party without 1 seat. That's the people of India. And Indians are the brilliant and brightest. And Telugu people are especially more smarter than anybody in the world. You see the CEO of Microsoft, Telugu Bida, out of millions of smart people. I had the privilege of bringing Bill Gates to India in 1997 when Dev Gowda was Prime Minister.